Hey everyone. Welcome back to VFX Rendering. Today, I'm exploring something both mathematical and magical, the abstract Voronoi effect. In mathematics, a Voronoi diagram is a partition of a plane into regions close to each of a given set of objects. It can also be classified as a tessellation. In the simplest case, these objects are just finitely many points in the plane, called seeds, sites, or generators. For each seed, there is a corresponding region, called a Voronoi cell, consisting of all points of the plane closer to that seed than to any other. Voronoi diagrams have wide applications, from science and technology, and of course, in art and 3D design. If you're curious, I definitely encourage you to dig deeper. But for now, let's jump into Cinema 4D and see how I can create a stunning abstract Voronoi effect using the Voronoi Fracture Generator. Let's start with a human head model as our base mesh. Apply a Voronoi Fracture Generator. Inside the Sources tab, take a quick look at the point generator, distribution. When adjusting the point amount or seed value, you'll see how the surface breaks into corresponding Voronoi cells. To make the partition surfaces more visible, go to the Object tab, increase the offset fragments to 0.4 cm, and select Hull only. Next, let's create our own custom point generator, distribution for more control and abstract results. Start with a circle object with a radius of 50 centimeters. Adjust P, Y to 55 centimeters so it's close to the center of base mesh. In the Object tab, increase the points to 200. Now apply a displacer deformer. Select shader as noise. Inside the noise shader, set the animation speed to 1 and loop period to 5, matching the total number of frames in the scene. Create a matrix. Set its mode to object, and assign the circle as the object. Adjust rate to 5% so the matrix moves along with the circle. Use this matrix as a point generator, distribution for the Voronoi fracture. Next, create a flower object with inner radius of 0 cm and outer radius of 40 cm, and set its plane to XZ. Use the flower as another point generator, distribution for the Voronoi fracture. Now keyframe different parameters to diversify the point sources of the point generator, distribution and Voronoi fracture. You can see the Voronoi cells change, creating an abstract, evolving Voronoi effect. Let's give our mesh some thickness. add a cloth surface generator, set subdivision to 0, and thickness to 0.1 centimeters. Then smooth out the geometry with a subdivision surface. Now let's add color to the Voronoi cells. Use a fracture object, and set the mode to explode segments. In effectors, add a plane effector and color mode as field's color. In the Fields tab, add a random field. In the Color remap, change the color mode to gradient. You can pick a color scheme that matches your style. Also in the Field settings, change the noise type until you find one that fits your look. Here I'm using Cell Voronoi. Hit play, and you'll start to see a beautiful, colorful, abstract Voronoi effect appear. But wait, there are still gaps between the cells. Let's fix that. Create a null group, rename it. And copy the existing Voronoi setup and generators into this group. In the Object tab, select Invert and reduce the offset fragment to around 0.3 centimeters. Optionally, add a displacer deformer to this new inner structure. Tweak the parameters until you're happy with the final effect. Then play to see the final version in motion. And that's it. I've just created a beautiful abstract Voronoi effect using the Voronoi Fracture Generator in Cinema 4D. This technique is a perfect blend of mathematics, motion design, and visual art, giving you a lot of creative freedom to experiment. If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to VFX Rendering for more inspiration. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.